Yo, yo, yo. What's happening, folks? Pretty obviously missing some folks. But hope everyone's doing all right. This loop is gonna give you a seizure. Let's do this. That better? That should be better, right? I hope it is. Kind of like the be right back screen, you know what I'm saying? But welcome to another episode of Monday Night Turbo Double XP Edition. Difference with this one is it's Double XP Edition for sure. Which means, instead of trolls, you have actual moolah on the line, man. What's happening, Sea King? I see Lame Time over there. Dylan the Goat's here as well. So, yeah. So, let me show you what it's actually up to right about now, right? Is this for FT? It's 2 out of 3 for the Swiss. But let me show you something. So we're literally at $155 right now. and that's the beginning. The pop bonus was added by myself, right? And then you have the co-host Super V chiming in as well with 50. So now we're literally at $155. But let me shill some stuff quick fast. Welcome to another edition, like I said, of Monday Night Turbo, episode 214. Basically, thanks for doing this. Yeah, anytime, man. Took the reins of the departure of Monday Night Fightcade. Monday Night Fightcade is now under new management, which is powered by this guy. So at this point now, you know, Matrimonial Cup 2, is this the sequel to the big event last fall? No, I mean, this is the second time we're actually doing a Matrimonial for Monday Night Turbo. So that's why it says Matrimonial Cup 2. That's why. But let me show some stuff quick fast. So you see that with the Monday Night Turbo. Then, not to mention, we got Tuesday Night Fights. Tomorrow's supposed to be Alpha 2. So it's going to be on Riz's channel. So if you do shill at Riz1. Right, you shill him, you follow his channel. He will be hosting Alpha 2 tomorrow, and then pretty much the week after is going to be ST again. So it's every other week for ST. And then not to mention, you got Super Lore Boys. He just finished Boss's episode. If you definitely want to listen to it, you know, join, obviously, you know, follow his stream. Like, you know, follow his stream, subscribe to his stream. It's also, there's a link towards the Discord with the ST Illuminati page and everything. And also, he has his YouTube as well. So, give his YouTube a follow. And let's not forget, you know, the homies from the seventh continent, Mexico. you know, they have their own Mexican Mass series for many games. For those who don't know, they also do also ST. So it's on Hokuto's channel. They had one this past Sunday. So when you get a chance, give Hokuto a follow. Give him a follow and a subscribe. Let's get this man some Twitch bucks. So, you know, give him a follow. And shout out to the whole Mexico crew. Folks is awesome. Like, 8-0 and everything. Yo, Tiger Lily, what's going on? How you doing? Just not to mention, apart from the Matcherino, there's a new marketplace right there with these four by five postcards. It's $10. So in the Matcherino below, you'll see there's the section for that. Okay, sorry about that. So, but yeah, these sits are dope. I suggest everybody get it. And it's some dope stuff made by 8-0's Rife. So, definitely take a look at these and like them if you want. And let's not to forget the 2X in the Mirror is back. Now, originally it was supposed to be the 30th, but it got pushed back. And it was supposed to be the 6th, but it also got pushed back. So, there will be an announcement for the next... for the actual date when it's coming up, but definitely tune in. This is this tournament that started the Shill Boys between myself and Riz, and it's coming back with a 6th iteration. But this is going to be a Star Cup edition. So tune in and see what's up with that. And last but not least, we got Super Lucha Gallera. Mexico fight between the two continents of Mexico and USA. Is almost every bi-weekly. So I think the next one might be this, if not this week, this Friday, it might be the following Friday that's coming up. So definitely tune in and enjoy the fight night. And let's not forget, right now, we are joined by the co-host of Monday Night Turbo, Super V.
Hey, guys. Hope everyone's well.
Yo, okay, I can't pronounce that, but you know what? Thank you for the follow. Really appreciate that.
It seems like we are just missing Tega.
Oh, Ari? Hey, Kayla, what's happening?
Yeah. All right. But otherwise, everyone else is here, and whenever you want, I can shuffle the brackets and we can start.
All right. Let me message this man. But
sorry, guys, for the delay. It's usually, as you know... It's usually like this.
Yeah, it's usually like this.
2 minutes off schedule.
But we got 15 people. I thought I'd see more. I mean, we got over 100. If we got over $155, you know, that's the lore right there. 155. So let's just spam that 55 emote because it's at 55. Let me see. Where is this right here? 55. Boom. Can you explain? Can you explain why that man is becoming a regular? Well, that's because the game is growing on him. That's exactly what it is, Krieg. I mean, you used to be like that until you just said you don't like the game, so... Who knows? But he likes it.
Surprisingly.
Surprise, yeah.
Yeah. I thought he'd play it like 2 days and like give up on the week that he promised.
Oh yeah, I agree. I thought he would really give up. I thought he would have gave up maybe after day three. But he toughed it out, so I'm actually proud of him. Yo, Lacarn Zero. Thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciate it. Oh, y'all ain't shit. Hey, we're just honest, bro. I mean, we didn't really expect you to really stick it out. I mean, you kept saying the game. You kept saying the game was head ass. So I'm like, oh, okay. Yo, Joktioff, thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciate it. You paid me for a week. Why would I not do a week? I mean, I just answered the question. The answer was, we thought that you weren't going to do it. Because we thought that the game, it's not your speed. You play the game like a head ass. I mean, that's how we are.
Don't take it the wrong way. It's so different, as you know already, from like the newer games. Mm-hmm. So for the people that are used to those games, they can't or will not or won't be able to play most of the time the older games.
Exactly.
So apologies for doubting you.
You'll be all right, man. All right. Okay, so has everybody checked in, bro?
Yeah, I got everyone in. Everyone's in the lobby. Damien just had to reboot his modem, but we can start. He'll be back in no time. So.
I'm just going to lean on.
Let me process the check-in results.
All right. Don't feel bad.
No. Okay, let me shuffle the brackets, and we can start. Right. I shuffle five times. One, two, three, four,
five.
Okay, and tournament is started.
All right.
Round one is a go.
Round one is a go indeed. Let's see what woo we have. So we got DJ Vanilla versus Hakuto. Anthro versus Scuzzbucket, Sea King versus Damdai, Pit versus Oh snap, that's funny. the first match he gets is a claw. That's hilarious. Assassin versus Joktioff. Oh, that's a Cammy Mirror. That's nice. 8-0 versus Demonio and Fat versus Black Riven. Man, there's a lot of mirror matches in this first round. Need a comma in your follow. Thank you. Thanks, Dad. No problem.
Could be a good week. A lot on the line here. Over $150. We Man, got
why
the...
Is it, why is it, okay, that doesn't make any sense. Man, it literally says 7-0. So, don't know what's up with that. Yeah, it's 1-2. Alright, so... Whenever folks are ready to get in, right... We can literally get in. And you know what? Why not? Let's just watch this amazing display of Cammy theatrics that we're about to watch here. Oh, never mind. He's opting to play Assassin's opting to play Guile.
Interesting. I've never seen him play Guile.
Man, you need the lobby link. This guy.
Oh, who is that?
Taiga.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah,
let me
give that to him.
I love how he doesn't want to play Cammy Mirrors.
I think for him it must be kind of a headache or something like that, but
it can't be as bad as Cammy against like Honda or like Osagat or Claw.
Nah, it's not bad. I guess he just doesn't like it. Who knows?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh yeah, by the way, folks, let me move the mouse because I'm not in John Madden mode. But this color pack is courtesy of Mr. MPG. So if MPG is in the chat, he could definitely give you a link towards his color pack. Which I'm shilling his color pack, you know what I'm saying? Oh, nice Sonic Boom. Assassin takes the first one. We got a stage change. How surprising. So, is Joktyov going to stick to Cammy? Of course he is. Soon we'll start seeing some transparent fireballs. Yeah, you know, the funny thing about that X, there was some complaints about that. So, there might be a time that we might have to stray away from the color pack. But, we'll see. Oh, nice flash kick. Assassin is not given the time of day. Nice air sweep.
He knows his character. He knows how to fight Cammy.
Yeah. I didn't think he would choose Guile. That's the funny thing about it. Yes, it should be original during tournament. Well, I completely agree with you. I mean, it should be original, but, you know, not a lot of people have really complained too much about it, so we're giving it a go. But there is some people that the color pack is not working for. I like it. Counter pickle. Look, oh, this guy. Yo, Arch Villain, what's happening, bro?
Hey, Arch Villain.
Oh, what a that throw did nothing. Oh, what a back fist. Yeah, that was definitely gonna happen there. And that's the first game so far.
Good stuff.
Yeah, good stuff to Assassin. Didn't expect the Guile pick, but that was pretty interesting, though.
Of all the counter matches, he does it against Cammy. I find it funny.
Telshin, what's happening, bro? Oh, nice rock bottom. Oh, you could have just did it again. Why? And that's it for that. A0 takes it. Like I said, did not really expect A0 to join, but you know, he's been a pretty much avid supporter. So I'm happy about that. Okay, so Pit versus Tega. I guess this one just started too. So, fun fact, this man did. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah, fun fact, you know, this man did said that he was gonna, you know, bust my kneecaps if he had a Claw first round. Guess I'm gonna be expecting that soon.
And it's Pit's Claw.
Yeah.
You know, not an easy Claw to deal with.
Oh boy. DP? He's gonna DP? Okay, that was the attempt. Ow. I think it's mad laggy, I think. It might be laggy for him because the way how this is buzzing. See, like that. The way how it's buzzing like that, either they complete their match or it's just, or spectator mode just, spectator mode just crashed. Are you seeing this delay? I mean, I am seeing the delay. If it's unplayable, you should have just said something. That's the thing. We give folks the chance to say something that if it's unplayable. But if you're ready to gate, this is definitely unplayable. I mean, you're already up 1-0. If it was 0-0, I would have said let's do a coin flip. But it's definitely 1-0. So, ow. Oh my god.
Yeah, this is
pretty rough.
If we're seeing the specs,
yeah,
these drop, who knows how bad it is actually in game for them.
Yeah. A lot of bzzzt.
Wow.
With lag and all, this man did the DP. With lag and all. Wow. Impressive. Oh, he got hit by the tail. Ow. That was, I'm guessing this is for, yeah. That was supposed to be DP. Right, match point for Pit. Ow.
Nice, air to air.
Yeah. This might be rip. Yeah, that's rip. That's the end of that. Definitely apologize about the unplayable. I'm guessing for Pit, it was also just as bad as well. Just a reminder, if a match is unplayable, please let me know. And, you know, just kind of follow the steps if you have to restart your modem and router. And if it happens again, then it'll have to resort in a coin flip. But it has to be 0-0. Kind of have to make it fair with that one. But round two is a go. So we got Tay versus DJ Vanilla, Pit versus Kayla, Hakuto versus Fact, H-Zero and Damdai, Joktioff versus Airthrow, Sea King versus Demonio, Scuzzbuckets versus Assassin. I found out the same time y'all did? No, that's unfortunate. Which match you want to watch?
Damdai H-Zero is always intriguing. I know we'll probably see them towards the end.
All right, let's do that. So some Damdai and H-Zero. All right, so folks, this is some Tuesday Night Fight stuff. So this is just going to be, this is pretty much going to be what it is. Now, you know, from the previous times, H-Zero had Damdai's number, but Damdai always found a will to win. So, you know, oh, nice sweep, a good overhead. Alright, that's a good red fireball right there. Alright, that's a good blue fireball just to get the knockdown. Yo, stand medium to just stuff that. And if you hear some popping, that's some fireworks folks just going off with. And, oh, no DP?
Yeah, that was crucial right there.
Oh.
Oh. Damien probably not happy with life right now. After that round one loss.
Hell no. I'd be unhappy as shit too.
good weight there, didn't a budge after H0's Tiger Knee. I'm wondering if he's playing on the snack box.
Yeah, by the way he's looking, he kind of is. Yo, the Saiyan with the host. Thank you very much for the host, the Saiyan. Very appreciate it. Looked that.
Like possibly.
He got another super. Oh, that was one chance. Oh boy, that was two chances. That was bro.
Yeah, no fireball cancel after the low forwards there. Not sure.
Oh, no DP by H0. Oh, good throw. Oh, you landed on the food fireball. Another one more for stun. But that stun is gone now.
Perfect scenario for Damien. He's got super and he's got Osaga in the corner. He can kind of wait this out a little bit. Let the time tick and try to build a second meter.
Oh, that's a good jump in, but Osaga is still alive.
Just block Damien. Or not. Good first game by Damien there.
Mm-hmm.
So H0 locks in with Osagat.
Yeah, I don't expect him to go Ultan. I don't expect him to go Ultan in this one. He won't do it.
Yeah. Another ideal scenario for Damien with super and having Osaga in the corner. Nice.
Yo, that stand medium punch is so clutch.
Seriously, that's the second time he's gotten it.
You can tell right now, you know, how Damdai is pretty patient. How in his approach, but he's getting bombarded with these. He has to be careful. But H0 has to be careful.
Ooh, that super on the neutral jump. H0 is playing very patiently. Not many forward jumps. A lot of neutral jumps, but no forward jumps to contest Damien's fireball game. I'm used to seeing him do more forward jumps. Now an ideal situation for H0, having Ryu in the corner here. Probably not easy to super those neutral jumps. I'm sure Damien was hoping for a trade there and a tie round, a double KO.
Yeah, he was hoping, all right.
Okay, Fei Long stage now. I know H0 likes Ryu's stage because it's slower. I'm sure he has more time to react to jump ins with DP. I love that walk-up sweep.
Yeah. Such a trademark.
He's pumping. Oh, those are two super opportunities there.
Oh, no.
That's probably a super.
Yep. Oh, what a Tiger Knee.
Yeah, that jab DP was probably a super.
Is this stage slower? No.
It is, I think, but not as slow as Ryu stage.
Yeah, Ryu stage is pretty damn slow. But this Sage, it's not slow. It just, it has no moving parts. So basically it's like, you know, I think the speed's pretty all right on Fei Long stage. But nothing moves in this stage. It only moves when the round ends.
Ooh, Damien missing fireballs.
Oh my god, what a jump roundhouse.
8-0 takes it, 2-1. Let me update those scores quickly.
Yes, sir.
And we will go, okay, round 3's ago.
All right, folks.
Oh, and guys, please donate to the Matcherino, or use the promo codes, I mean.
Yeah. You type in !! Matcherino. It'll send you to the Matcherino link. Currently, it's still at... I didn't even know about... Hold on, let me find out what is it at. It's still currently at... Oh, it's at 157 now. So, it went up some few dollars. But, definitely donate more to the Matcherino. It's top 3 payout because, you know, we already have the, troll coin shower. But, yeah, it's top 3 payout at this current moment. So, alright, but round 3 is a go, so let's see. Who can we watch? Look like Taiga takes a break. That's exactly what it is. Taiga takes a break. Alright, so, let's see. So we got Joktia versus Black Riven, Assassin versus Demonio, Hokuto versus Pit, DJ Vanilla versus Kayla, Sea King versus Aerithro, Scuzz versus H0, Fak versus Damdai. Okay, so let's watch some Black Riven versus Joktioff.
So we get a Claw Cammy match.
Yeah.
Mexico breeds claw players.
Yeah.
From Hokuto to Pit to Fak to Black Riven.
Yeah.
Four, you know, pretty solid claw players right there.
Mm-hmm. Well, these DPs are clean by Doctioff. Very clean.
Convincing game one. Yeah, he has Dictator too. But I don't assume this is much better. It isn't.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, like right there, the hooligans are going to be much more difficult for Dictator to deal with. Again, 3 in a row. 4? Doesn't need to. Super chip. Yeah, James, we have 4. Usually we have a ton of leads. From Demonio to Scuzz to Snoopy to DJ Vanilla. That's 4 chuns right there.
Yeah, shout out to character variety.
Oh yeah.
Shout outs to
It's all business. Yeah. Internees.
Yeah, that's what it is. Shout outs to character variety.
DJ Vanilla won that fast? Wow. Against Keela, huh? Good stuff to him.
Ah, snap. The brother from another mother, Bazooka, with the raid of 7. Everybody, welcome. Welcome from France. Welcome from another edition of Monday Night Turbo, which is Matcherino based. And Joktioff takes that one. Very nice on his end. Yeah, hey, Bazooka, how are you doing tonight, sir? Hope all is well with you. Hope all is well with you, my friend. We here, just doing this tournament. You know what I'm saying? And well, we're trying to see a game come up, but that was a... Okay, so we closed that. Okay, so obviously that one's done. So yeah. But yeah, welcome, France. How you guys are doing tonight? I hope everyone's doing well. Oh my God, look at these ass colors. Like, these colors are ass. Like, we talking some plain ass colors. What? My man did back. Oh my God, wow. Can we get some love with that hard read win against Dick and beating Claw? Well, yeah, I mean, I'm not disagreeing with that. I'm not disagreeing with that. Yo, Bass Veroso, thank you for the follow. I greatly appreciate it. We're just winding down. There's pretty much like two matches left. When it gets to round five, I'll give the standings. But we're just going through this motion. Look like Sea King and Air Throw just started. So why not? Let's just watch this match anyway.
Nice to see Air Throw in this tourney.
Oh yeah, absolutely. But
It
you know who I like? I like Sea King, the 8-0 killer. Oh, nice
Yes,
tosses.
he can. Is improving.
Oh, nice fireball by Air Throw. Didn't even took the chance of Sea King was gonna reversal super, but I like the idea. That's some good stuff.
Crazy how, like, back in the day, I used to learn. I learned some stuff from Air Throw, his boxer. Like back in 2010, 2011, and he doesn't even use the character anymore. I like the just the Stampier's dizzy punish there.
Yeah, it's so basic, but I love it.
Yeah, he kept him in the corner. Got some damage. He did what he wanted, I guess.
Oh, eight. Oh,
Ooh.
snow. Oh, another dizzy.
Oh, I thought he was going for the American reset there. The hit punish and then throw.
Is he gonna get double? My man really got double perfect. Like what? My man really got a double perfect. Okay.
Yeah, and no TODs there either. Just cross up, jab, throw, or frame trap.
Oh, Hakuto posted a fun fact. He said Air Throw built his super gun.
Oh wow, really, Hokuto? Shout outs to Air Throw then. He helped a few of us out in various ways. Yeah, I learned Brenda canceling from Air Throw, actually, through a forum post on the DBT website. Don't blow this website. He was posting there on the Boxer thread. So I asked him. So I always appreciate that.
Oh, that was supposed to be super, but that's wasn't there. But you can get it with a DP. Fun fact about Air Throw, yeah. I think the very first ST tournament I watched was on the Don't Blow This channel. Before, everybody else kind of just chimed in and everything. That and between DTB and IE Battlegrounds. Oh, nice throw by Sea King. Air Throw is from Seattle, alongside Zass and me. Oh, so that means you're definitely friend with Large Man then, right? And Doughboy, Yo, Doughboy's my my dog, man. Nice. That's what's up, Axel Kelly. And Doughboy, aka Mr. Facebook Millionaire. And Airthrow takes it.
And I'll update the scores so we can quickly go to the next round. So, round four is a go, guys.
Oh my god. Calendar. Thank you for the follow. Shout out to Argentina. Thank you. Thank you for the follow, Calendar. Greatly appreciate it. We have custom super colors. Nice. Yes, Ultrason. We do. Shout outs to Mr. MPG. I don't know where his 16-year-old ass at, but you know, this is his color pack at this point. Yeah, from Argentina. Oh yeah, I know. I know you're from Argentina, bro. I know you are, man. I know you are, bro. Shout out to Argentina regardless, though. All right, so we got DJ Vanilla versus Damn Die, Tay versus Assassin, Hakuto versus Scuzz, Aerithrow versus Black Riven, Demonio versus Pit, H0 versus Joktioff, Kayla versus Fak, which means I think Sea King takes a break. That's exactly what it means. Sea King takes a break. So you know what? Let's watch some crazy Mario Ryu. If you know what I mean.
Let's do it.
I'm from Connecticut. Okay, so shouts out to Connecticut as well. How do you know I'm from Argentina? Well, two things. One, you usually post your matches with the Argentinian ST scene. And two, you usually say in the server you're from Argentina. So there you have it. Oh, time to guess. Oh no, he just wall dived too early. Oh, nice DP. Overhead. Oh, he went for the double overhead. Oh, the Super Mario Brothers. Yeah, I really gotta get a sound for that. Oh, you thought you was going to get them coins. You thought you was going to get them coins, right? Yo, high times, what's up? Oh, what a jab DP. Oh, the doink. Oh my god, baited. You know, I give. Oh my god! I think Fak definitely second guessed that dive. Oh, this might be it. Yo, you see how funny it is? Like the screen didn't really position itself after that super. That is funny. But I give Fak credit where it's due. The only Mexican claw. That plays on keyboard. So that's impressive. Okay, guess. Oh, what a DP. And these Tatsus. Super? Yep. Oh my god, yo, Fak. Alright, what's the guess? Roll a crystal flash. In the corner, doink. Oh my god, he didn't get out in time. Kayla's on a point right there. Calendar, you see Argentina fights? Yeah, I watch it. I watch your fights. You're very good Honda. Very solid Honda, sir. Oh. Roll a crystal flash. Oh, you know what? I gotta say, Fak is really baiting Kayla. Oh my god, what a fireball. Oh, with the Super Mario again. And the Super Mario again. It's tied up. 1-1. Alright. Game number three. Oh, the doink again. Oh, caught him in the air trying to do the Super Mario. Every time when he gets hit, it's like my man does not get the coins. You know how Super Mario, when he gets the mushroom and he gets hit by something, he goes to Small Mario? That's exactly what Kayla happens. Oh, nice block. Oh my god. Guess. Yeah, there we go. Backside match point. Oh, nice doink. Okay, that was a good block by Kayla. Got him with the Super Mario. Yeah, he's out of the corner. Okay, that was a good DP. That was a late one, too. But pretty good awareness of getting out of that mix-up. Call it the Kayla mix-up. Okay, that's a good course. That's... Oh, wow. That Tatsu still was there. Throwing him. Super's coming. Okay. Trade. Oh, no. Got hit by the fireball trying to go up. Match point for both of them now. Oh, caught him with the doink. Too early on the wall dives, but... Oh, yeah. Kayla is looking good. All right. Good slide. Oh, early one. All right, that's a good one. Oh, Super Mario. Oh my God, reversal flip kick. Good block again by Kayla. Oh no, but he got caught by the doinky doink. And Fax takes it 2-1. That was some good stuff by Fax there. Yeah, E-Honda is very poor and humble. I would say personally, it's an understatement, but I understand. Just like me, I'm pretty humble about my own stuff as well. But, yeah. I think this is pretty much the last match that's happening. Assassin versus Taiga. Fun fact about Taiga. One of my closest friends. He plays Street Fighter V, but he's started to play some ST. Did it grow on him? Maybe it did. But I think that's pretty much the end of round 4. And I think Super V stepped away for a second. No, he didn't. It's got updated. Alright, so let me show you guys. And round 5 is a go, by the way. So let me show you guys pretty much what the standings look like, right? So, we gotta close that shit out. Alright, so pretty much the standings that we got. We got Hakuto with a clean 4-0. And we got Scuzzbucket at 3-1. And... really good Akuma, one of the best. Yeah, 8-0 is at 3-1 in third. Pit got 3-1 as well. DJ Miller 3-1. Yo, Mr. Hotwood, thank you for the follow. Damn Dies at 7th place and 2-2. And Demono Debian, that it's a lot of 2-2s. Holy shit! And you know we got the 0-3s out here, but they still got a chance to do something. They still have a chance to do something. And let's not forget. The Match Reno. So the Match Reno is literally at $159 right now. There's a sponsor quest right here. There's a couple of sponsor quests that you guys can do. You can follow. You can join the Discord server. You can like, visit. There's a follow to Match Reno as well. The highest paid contributors is pretty much myself because that's the pop bonus right there by me. And Super V with $150. Everybody donated with using the coupon code, which I greatly appreciate it. So, at this point right now, you can also, let me also show you guys, there's also the Super Lucha Cayeta postcard set that you can also donate as well. You can also buy it. It's $250 is made by 8-0's wife. $250 goes to 8-0, and $250 goes to Riz. Let's not forget the sticker pack as well, and a couple of sticker packs that's there. It's still available, So please, if you can, please donate to the Match Reno. It goes to the players. It doesn't go to me. It really doesn't go to me. But meanwhile, back to our regular stuff. Let's go to what's up. Am I out of the tournament? No, you're not out of the tournament. You just since it's an odd amount of people air throw, you pretty much get a bye this round. So you can go eat until it's done, but don't go too far because it's 2 out of 3 and they kind of go quick. So yeah. All right. Black River versus Taiga. Oh, up kicks. Can't jump in. You can't jump in on Black River. Oh boy, that's supposed to be DP. Oh, that's supposed to be DP too. Yeah, that's supposed to be DP. Three times that's supposed to be DP. Three times, guys. Three times. Just letting you know that. Oh boy, here we go. So Black Riven has this really interesting way of just teabagging for some sort of reason. I mean, sometimes if you're gonna disrespect the players, nice. If you get it, yeah. You know, I already said it. You know, if you're gonna disrespect the players, then you know you pretty much don't belong in the tournament. And I let it be known before because I won't tolerate such things like that. I mean, teabagging is fine and all, but but that's just childish. But to him, he considered it fun. I don't know why is that, but it's weird. But you know, to me personally, it's kind of stupid. That's just me. It is funny in casuals, but. I mean, I see it in Street Fighter V. Black Riven is from the LOL community. He doesn't represent ST Mechs in any way. Okay, I got you. I don't need stupid shit like that. That's the thing. Cause what's LOL? I think probably League of Legends. Because he is the same person that did said some pretty racist shit towards me, and I had to G-tab him. But you know, he did apologize. But yeah, I ain't a fan of that stuff. Hey, don't care if it's fun. It's not allowed. Don't give a shit if it's fun. It's like Blanca crouching. I don't care. You're not playing Blanca. You're playing Claw. I'm gonna fucking respect people. Kidding me? Anyway, back to that. Okay, so Scuzz. That boxer shadow is the dopest shit I've ever seen. Oh yeah, you know, courtesy of, you need this color pack. Okay, I'm gonna reach out to the creator one more time, because this man is the one who created the color pack. If you know him, his name is MPG. I'm trying to contact this boy, but this boy is like disappeared. I wish I had the link towards his. I wish I had the link towards it, but I don't have the link. Actually, maybe I do. Maybe. Maybe I do have the link. I don't know where. Let me just make sure if it's. Is it still working? Oh, it does work. Okay, never mind. All right, folks. So, I do have the link towards the color pack. Right? And also give the creator of the color pack a follow as well. Give the creator the link of the color pack a follow and give him some props as well. He worked pretty hard at this. Oh, what a throw! The rock bottom, man. Yeah, don't worry, Archvillain. I completely agree, but you know I'm a fair person, so. You know, I gave him it's the one strike. How do I get the color pack? So I just posted a link right there, right? It comes with the download link for the JR1 file, right? All you gotta do is just replace the JR1 file in your ROMs folder. But please, I beg you, it should have instructions. Well, unzip those ROMs. No, you don't have to. It's just copy and paste. But I'm asking folks, before you even think about doing it, make sure copy your old JR1 file somewhere else and then put that in there. Just letting you guys know that. Just saying. So. Oh, nice upkicks. You're a better dude than I, Mega Man? Yeah. Well, that's me. That's me. Mr. Nice Guy. So Pit was. Get your claw. There you go. Oh, he went for the doink and he got. Wow. And classy. Yeah, thanks, man. Oh, he has 7 seconds to do something. No. What's the doink? It's pretty much that bullshit that thing that claw does. The straight claw instead of doing the Barcelona fly stuff. I don't know what the actual name is. Is that what it's called? Claw air spike? Yeah. But we call it the doink because it's like a doink. You get hit, it's like doink. You know what I'm saying? You mean down up punch? Yeah, that thing. Yeah. That. Oh boy, this might be bad. Oh, he backs off. But why did he back off? He should have just did it. Oh no, Scuzzbucket must be kicking himself right about now. That's so funny. Yeah, start calling it the Doink, man. It's definitely a goat name. It's definitely the goat name. It really is. Okay. Well, with that round completed, right? Let's just push this over here quick fast. With that round completed, right? Make sure that the what was the score with Tay Black Riven? It was 2-0. Okay, we gotta update that. Holy shit. Yo, Tusk Vision with the host, thank you very much. Okay, round 6 is a go. We got Assassin versus Black Riven, Sea King versus Tay, Pit versus H0, Hakuto versus Demono Debian, Scuzzbucket versus Damdai, Fact versus DJ Vanilla, Kayla versus Airthrow, which means I think Pit takes a break. No, Pit does not take a break. I think not fact either. Who takes a break? I forgot who takes a break. No, Kayla. Nah, well, oh, confused. Don't care. All right, let's go ahead and just watch a match anyway. But I mean, it's cool. It's cool, but like I said, most people takes it as disrespect, and you doing it in the middle of the game, bro, that's just kind of weird. But yeah. Oh, you got the bye. Okay. All right. Well, you sit and watch the show while I load up a match. So we got Air Throw versus Kayla. Whenever this decides to load, though. Oh, that's supposed to be super. Super. Why? Bro. Yo, Air Throw, please. Like, why, bro? That round was all you. Oh my God. It's all, well. Ow. Okay. So as we progress in this, oh my God, this fireball pressure by Kayla. He's not going nowhere. Super Mario into super, but good blocks by Air Throw. Oh God, anti-air sweep. And more of these fireballs. Man, this is rough as fuck, bro. But Kayla is about to have. Damn, no clean DP. Match point by Kayla. Okay, that's a good sweep. Oh, but he backs off. Don't know why. I thought he would have got something started, but he just gets jumped right into a fireball. Oh no. Yikes. And yep, that's it. Kayla takes a 2-0 right there. Man, what a blow up. I could not recover from that first round. Yeah, man. That first round, that was all you, bro. What, like, that was crazy. I felt like if you would have got the super off, you would have had like a really good momentum. Really good momentum. That's what I think would have happened. You would have had some good momentum there. I think Sea King and Tega is finished. I think what is left? We got Damn Die and Scuzz Bucket. Kayla's zoning it was godlike. Yeah, Kayla is an interesting one. Yeah, new Ken versus Ryu is really rough. Cause Ryu could just really sit there. He doesn't really have to go in. Ken has to be literally on the offensive to get what he wants. I'd rather fight Ultagot? Man. Oh no! Oh, that blows. That really blows. Alright, we're going to my home country in the USSR. Yeah, it is hilarious. Oh my god, what a super. So... okay, I feel like I really think Damn Dice must be playing on the snack box. It really is. Oh, standing medium kick. Yeah, usually that's a clean DP. But you know what? I can't deny what Damn Dice does, because this man is doing some good stuff anyway. Yeah, you see Scuzz is buffering it. But Damn Dice has to be careful. Okay, that's good. He can afford that. He can afford it. He can definitely afford it, so that's cool for him. But round three, this is the last game. This is the last game for both folks. Oh, nice up kicks by Scuzz. Oh, flip kick. And flip kick. Oh, good block. Itatsu out of there. Now he has to be careful with super. Yeah, at this point right now, Damn Dice buffering it. And there goes the super. So, oh my god. The jump roundhouse, the stand roundhouse just got tore up. Did Damn Dice play in the Snatchbox last tournament? I think he did, yeah. Maybe. Don't know. Hey, Super V, where are you? I haven't heard you for a while, bro. But good job to Scuzz Bucket. He takes that clean 2-1. At this point right now. We're round 7. You submitted the wrong score. Jesus Christ. Okay. Gonna have to fix that, I guess. Don't start next round. No, it's fixed. Don't worry about it. It's fixed. It's 2-1. Yeah, it's fixed. Don't worry about it. 2-1 for Damn Dot. 2-1 for Scuzz Bucket. That's what happened. All right. Round matchups will be different. I just did refresh. You have 2-1 against Scuzz, right? Was that the score that you feel like you had wrong? Let a bro know. But I think Super V cleared it up anyway. So we're good. But alright. Let me check this Matcherino right now. So this Matcherino, oh man, we had $160. That is awesome. Thank you guys for the contribution. Greatly appreciate it. Everybody using up that using that coupon code. Greatly appreciate that. So let's go ahead and watch a match. Let's go Assassin Hakuto. I haven't watched too much of Hakuto. Win. Oh my god, time to guess. Okay, good block by Assassin. Oh, what a DP. Oh, good punish. Dude, what the f- okay. Oh, Hakuto gets the first one. Let me see what's going on with them, though. I legit think you are mute or something like that. Hold on a moment. Tay93 is Tega. That's his name. Alright. I'm unsure what's going on. I'm trying to contact with Super V's what happened to Super V. But I can't hear him. And Hakuto takes that one. Okay. Alright, so let's see. We still have some matches going on here. Minnesota Vikings Cammy. Yeah. Good eye, Kiyoya. Very good eye. Yo, Reno, Wolfpack. What's happening, bro? Hope all is well with you, man. How's the beach and the sand? Where is the Mario's up again? But look like he's crowded today. Yeah, it's pretty crowded. Yeah, and it looked like Demonio takes that one. So at this point, I think the last couple of matches we got Fak. We got Fak and Hakuto. What is going on here? Okay, all right. Well, let's go ahead and watch Damn Die. Can I get a hold of Black Riven? All right. If it gets down to it, Sea King, if he doesn't appear in the next like 5 minutes or so. Oh, never mind. He's there. Oh, Zass, what's happening? Ow. Oh boy. Nice double KO. Oh snap, yo, weird looking hippo. What's happening, bro? I haven't seen you in a hot minute. I'm trying to find out what's going on with my partner in crime, Super V. I'm trying to call for him, but I don't know what's going on. I know he sees me. Oh, he probably... Wait, did he really rage? Did Dan not really rage quit? What the fuck just happened? Oh, very laggy. Oh, well, damn. Oh, Pit's connection is, Pit's connection must be doo-doo. Look like it is. So Tega was right. Okay. Tega was right. Okay, I think there's only two matches left, which is Tega and Air Throw versus Sea King and Black Riven. Oh, what a throw by Air Throw. Because that was literally an air throw that he did. Get it? Alright, Air Throw's on match point. Taiga, he can still come back. Okay, that's a good punish. Alright, that's a good jump in again. So, oh, good DP. That's a good trade. Oh, that was super. Oh, let's go, Taiga. Let's fucking go. He ain't dead yet, y'all. That's a clean jump in by Taiga. Oh, he could have had the stun if he did a DP. But it's still going on. Oh my god. Taiga can't make more mistakes. He has to be careful. No. Oh, he can punish. Oh. Taiga's at match point. Alright, that's a good DP by Taiga. Alright, good tech. Alright, that's a good fireball. Oh, yo, stand medium? Okay, oh my god, you went for the Tatsu. Oh, what a low forward fireball! My man did the Street Fighter V strats. Very nice. He did the Street Fighter V strats. Very nice. Good job. Good job to Taiga. Very good. I think this is pretty much the last round right here. With Sea King versus Black Riven. Yo, Rakurai. What is happening, bro? How are you? Oh, what? Wow, Black Riven. Alright, that's a good. So, Black Point for Black Riven. So, he's sticking with the Dictator. Okay, Psycho Crusher out, Psycho Crusher out. Oh. Okay, good throw. Okay, that's a good punish because, you know. Oh my god, he's getting poked. Alright, early super. Not sure why he did it. Oh, what? No, you got to be careful. Oh my god, the jump back roundhouse by Black Riven. That was smart. Very smart on his end with that one. I'm good. Can't sleep. Eh, what time is it over there? Must be like early in the morning or some shit. Must be early in the morning. Okay. Well, let's see. So, considering that the last two matches has to be reported, right? Which is, looks like Taiga won 2-1. I know Super V was on the call, but Taiga won 2-1. And then after that, we can start with round 8.
And round 8's to go.
All right. So in round 8, we got Pit versus DJ Vanilla, Hokuto versus Black Riven, Aerithrow versus Damdai, Taiga versus Kayla, H-Zero versus Assassin, Scuzzbucket versus Demona Debian, Sea King versus Joktioff, which means, I believe, who sits out? I think, Fax sits out. So he gets a bye. He sits out. All right. All right. Well, to the 54 folks, let me start by saying I greatly appreciate everybody being here on Double XP Monday. Greatly appreciate everybody being here once again. Donate to the Matcharino. The link is right there. So far, let me just shill the Matcharino one last time. Well, I can still shill it, but you know, let me just shill it regardless anyway, right? So we're pretty much at, I'll show you guys, we're pretty much at $160 currently. The sponsor quest is at the side here. You got the follow the Red Cross Gaming during the Discord. That pretty much adds 30 cents to the prize pool, and it goes to the Red Cross as well too. This is ST, not NL, right? Dylan, where have you been this whole tournament since it started? I'm just asking. But the shout outs to the top contributor, myself with a $100 pop bonus, and Super V with the $50, of course. Greatly appreciate that. And also, you know, the Super Lucha Kayeta postcard set is live. Shout outs to A0 and Riz for doing this. So definitely it's up for sale. It's $10. I mean, $250 goes to A0 and $250 goes to Riz, but $5 goes to the prize pool. I think this is pretty cool right there. And let's not forget the Azroy sticker pack as well. Azroy, shout outs to Azroy the homie. His sticker pack is legit. And also, you got the Super Lore Boys sticker as well by Riz, and the second one as well. So please, she'll keep adding more to the Matcharino. Really appreciate it. Yes. Yes, why not? Yes. Okay. You know what? Let's watch some 8-0 and Assassin quick fast, right? I haven't seen much of 8-0 because I've seen much of 8-0 on Tuesday nights. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, 8-0 is like that date that, you know, you're pretty much gonna see next week because you know you're gonna see next week. But he's legit the truth. So with his old god. And then Assassin can never sleep on this man. Can never sleep on Assassin. His cami is strong as shit. It's very strong. Very strong. And look how he's handling a really, really shitty ass matchup. Old God versus cami. Like, this cami sucks as much as Geef versus Honda. Even though Geef Honda is worse. But this match is pretty bad. But okay, he could have DP'd that neutral jump. Okay, good hooligan. Oh, he went for it again, but 8-0 was like ready for that. Oh, there's the hooligan. What's the setup? Oh my god, that's punishable. Another reason why that matchup sucks. Good anti-air sweep. That's a free... It's literally a free punish off that block DP of cami. So terrible. So terrible.
Seriously.
Yeah. Oh, good throw. What's the mix? Alright, he kind of throws him. Oh, not too sure what he went for there, but, oh. I just realized, Cammy's neutral jump animation is like you know, she has her hand going up, like she's just pushing the sky up. Oh man, match point for 8-0. Oh, clean DP. That was expected. Like, I mean, at times I feel like I don't even know what to say. Like, it'll be hard for Cammy to even build meter because she has to deal with those Tiger shots. Oh my god, what a punish, and that's it.
That's it.
Alright, so with Fak and a Pit doing their matches, which I think is going to be the last one, we can watch some Taiga versus Kayla. And look at these ass colors. Yeah, the matchup is so busted. Yeah, look at these ass colors right here. Like, these colors are so trash. Who even uses these regular colors anyway? Do you use these regular colors, Super V?
No, not at all.
Exactly. I don't use these shits either. Like, who the hell cares about... Who wants to see Orange Ryu? I think even before we had this color pack, the Orange Ryu is ugly as shit. I'm just going to say it as it is there. All right, now we're back to the regular colors. Rakurai says, I often feel in ST you need to learn at least 3 characters to be competitive in tournament. Well, yeah. It depends, though, because if you learn, like, one character that doesn't really have a bad matchup, like, for example, like Claw doesn't have really a bad matchup. Sim. I mean,
Sim.
Yeah. Sorry, you can go ahead.
I was just going to say Claw doesn't need a counter. Sim might need a counter for Claw, but otherwise Sim does fine against everyone else. And Chun could use a counter against Claw, but otherwise is fine against everyone else. And Boxer relatively is fine against everyone else. So it's like there's a few characters, at least I would say 4 or 5 that can manage solo. Mm-hmm. What were you going to say, Mega Man?
No, that was good. Well, you took the words out of my mouth with that one. I was going to say, like, characters like Sim, Claw, Old Got does fine, Chun, Boxer,
DJ. For the most part.
I think
if you know Claw, you don't need to know anyone else. Your biggest problem is probably the mirror. And maybe Boxer, maybe DJ. But those are probably in his favor, those matches. Yeah. Otherwise, Chun and Sim, Claw is the only issue, really, for them.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's going to be like a disadvantage match. So, and then Boxer does fine pretty much against everyone. So you have like a few characters, like the top tiers relatively do fine against everyone except Claw. And they do fine in those matches too. So.
Yeah.
Not new Ryu. Definitely not new Ryu.
What a comeback.
DJ probably does better than new Ryu to be a solo main. Because his hardest match is probably Sim. And even that one is pretty fightable.
Yeah.
Because one knockdown and you get an ambiguous cross-up. And it's game over for Sim if he guesses wrong. So, and DJ has all the normals, too, to fight against Sim.
Yeah. So. He does, yeah. And DJ does pretty okay against Old God as well. So.
Yeah, it seems like it. It seems like he can manage. It seems like it's definitely easier for DJ than it is for new Ryu. Like, DJ mains than new Ryu mains.
Yeah. Well, we're looking hippo. If a person like Valle can win with Ryu, that's just based off of experience. You know what I'm saying?
Hippo, the game has changed a lot in the past 10 years. It's changed a lot.
Oh yeah, so Damdai is using snack box.
Yeah.
Rakurai says, I basically hit a wall with an ST. Learning ST Ken isn't enough for me. Well, you got options. You got more to learn. That's for sure. You definitely got a lot more to learn. You can learn other characters. But I think that's pretty much the end
Yeah.
of round 8.
Seems like it. So 2-1 for Hokuto.
So at this point now, I guess that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead and we can go ahead and look at these standings quick fast, right?
Yep.
Now.
Ooh, damned eye barely made it. Damned eye, switch your stick. Go
All
back to
right.
traditional.
So at this point right now, we got first place is Hakuto with a good clean 8-0. 8-0 is a 6-2. Pitt's at 6-2. Scuzzbuck is at 6-2. Demono Debut is at 4-4 in fifth place. Assassin is 4-4. FAK is 3-4. Reason why is that because he's probably has the better rounds. And Damned Eye barely made it. The guy said, man, kill me already. Damned Eye barely
So,
made it at eight.
yeah. So the reason the reason FAK is ahead of Damien despite the wins is because the bye counts as a win. So you could pretty much say FAK went 4-4 with that bye. That's a plus one.
Yep.
So that could be misleading there. And DJ Vanilla and Jack Tiaf, as well as Kila and Black Riven, also got wins with their bye. However, their Buckholz is less than Damned Eye's, and their point differential is worse than Damned Eye's. So that's why Damned Eye got it. Got the eighth spot. That's why Damned Eye, in fact, got it over them. It seems like, yeah, the Buckholz takes priority after. Their buttholes are worse. Pretty much, yeah. Buckholz, buttholes, same thing. Buttholes,
The
same thing.
buttholes are worse, but all right. Now that we got that out the way, we have to prepare for the USSR Tower of Doom, which means this is Damned Eye's first time. At this point now, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna set up this USSR Tower of Doom, right? Because the brackets are finished and the stage is set. So that'll technically be our top eight. So for now, let me just shill a couple of things quick fast. So now we got, like I said, thank you all for coming for Monday Night Turbo, number episode 214. This is double XP edition, which means Match Reno is definitely involved. How far can you get without DP? Not far. So, and then let's not forget Tuesday Night Fights, was streamed by the homie Riz One. Basically, if you go ahead, you do shill at Riz One, right? Make sure you give him a follow, subscribe to his channel. Tomorrow he'll be doing Street Fighter Alpha 2 tournament. So basically, it's every other week you'll see some ST, but for now, for this week, ST is pretty much me at this point, right? So let's not forget Super Lore Boys. He just recently did Boss's chat, recording. So expect that episode to come out soon. Oops. And let's not forget the Mexico Mass series. Shout outs to the Seven Continent Mexico. They just did their first Mexico Mass series in a while. So it's a new season. When you shill at Hokuto, give Hokuto a follow. A follow to subscribe. He's running the ST side of things, but Mexico also has like a whole bunch of different games that they play. They have their Smash GG right there. You can look at their Facebook as well. And then there's their Twitter. So give them a like and a follow. And let's not forget, like I said, and along with the Match Reno, the 4x5 postcards for Super Lucha Calera, the 30th edition, and it is the 20th. It's $10. It's literally cool. The art is designed by Gabriella Art, which is Day Zero's wife. Shout outs to her. And you get a full color print and a back black. Well, that's a tongue twister right there, but I can't say it. But you know the deal with this one. And let's not forget the 2X in the Mirror 6. Originally, it was supposed to be the 30th. And originally, it was supposed to be the Sunday, but that's not happening. So, a new date will be announced by Riz. This is going to be in the a back print, like the tattoo on your back. Yes, Standai, like a tattoo on your back, sir. Yeah. So, oh my god, let me just go on to the next one. And last but not least is Super Lucha Cayeta. Every bi-weekly, there's a fight night between Mexico and USA. 30 just passed. 31 will be pretty soon. Tune in for 8-0. At this point right now, I need a 2 minute, maybe a 3 minute break, quick fast, and then we'll get started with the top 8. So, without further ado, I will leave you to the special time with Time with Super V.
Time with Super V. It's funny.
Oh, snap. Yo, Rito with the Prime sub. Yo, thank you for that, man. Greatly appreciate it. No break. Begin. Hey, hold your horses. Jeez, 30-year-olds, bro. I'm telling you.
I have no horses. Panda, you were doing pretty decently with the snack box. For like, what, less than 10 hours on it? 4 wins, that's pretty impressive. Going 4-4. Too bad Ryu's normals are like bleh, average at best. Character could jump in on Sam medium kick. I'm screwed. You have Stan Roundhouse, but Stan Roundhouse isn't that great, and you have Stan Fierce, that's situational, and you have Crouch Fierce. I guess crouching would be another input, so yeah, Stan medium kick probably better. I don't know how you're playing on that snack box. Freaking relearn the entire game. Not like you haven't put hundreds and thousands of hours into this game already. You have to relearn it. No thanks. I don't know if I could do it again. I don't know if I could relearn this game. I guess you still have your fundamentals. But like, execution's everything, and muscle memory's everything. And yeah, your reactions are great, but without the muscle memory and execution. Took however long to get to this point. I just know offline is coming back soon. I'm sure more people would probably get into the snack box. It's mostly picking one of like five characters. Tusk, what do you mean? DJ Vanilla, GG's. Thanks for joining, as always. If Tusk, if you're talking about like solo mains, yeah, even then it's not even five. It's, when's Mexico gonna get on this though, get some real respect? Nah, Mexico is not gonna get on it. They have like it seems like they have like an offline scene in a sense, like they get together and play offline. I doubt they'd start fresh with like snack boxes. Blessed offline. Speaking of which, the barbecue's this Sunday. I'm excited. Oh, Cali was good, by the way, as well. I got to play with the LA guys. Reno, who else was there when I was in LA? Reno, Andy Ma, Jeff Rocks, El Trouble, Silent Scope, Mucus came out. I'm missing two. I can't remember. Me, and then I think there's one other person I'm missing. Oh, Frank Punches. So it was fun. We had two super guns. Yeah, good stuff. Auto-tune California, love auto-tune. Reno was playing on a fight stick. Not, definitely not his specialty, but he's still really good on stick. Setup looked great. Yeah, it was. The only issue, if there was one, it wasn't that big of a deal. The one of the super guns, the audio died. Mucus put in his fight stick and the audio died after. Stick. Purple dick on his stick. But me and El Trouble were fine playing the rest of the night on the audioless ST super gun. We were in Jeff Rocks' garage. It was kind of cool. He had like his workout stuff all there. It is, but if it's towards the end of the night, it was quiet. So it's pretty easy for me to focus, despite not having sound, to like react with super to project with against projectiles.
Yeah, there must be some fun stuff there. But all right,
I want to say one more thing.
Oh, go for it!
Everyone, come out to the barbecue, June 6th.
Yeah,
at noon.
Oh yeah, tune in. If you can't come out, tune in. For sure. Alright, so now let's begin with this top 8 stuff, right? Let's show the bracket. Alright, so Super V, can you do the honors of explaining the USSR top Tower of Doom for Damned Eye, since this is his first time?
Of course. So pretty much Damned Eye, who is in 8th place, will work his way up. He will play FAC first, 7th. Winner of that plays 6th, and so on. 6th plays 5th, 5th plays 4th, and up until 1st place, where Hokuto is waiting. Every match before Grand Finals will be 1st to 2. Grand Finals will be 1st to 3, and it's single elimination at this point.
Alright. And he's like, no, explain, start. Okay. Alright, so let's go ahead and get FAC and Damned Eye in. And just a reminder, it's still 2 out of 3. it's literally still 2 out of 3 until grand finals, which is 3 out of 5. So, yeah. When is it? The 6th? Yes, it is. It's this Sunday. It's gonna. The stream will be up by like 12, I should say. By like 12 p.m. at best. And I still have to. I take the time to set up and all that good stuff. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. But all right.
They're in.
They are in indeed.
Okay, you guys can start.
Yeah. I'd like to get some predictions going.
Where's our prediction boy?
Yeah, AMC's not here. Marino could probably do it if he could.
Reno's too rich in trolls to want to do this job.
Too rich in trolls.
You'd have to pay him like, I don't know, in Bitcoin.
Hey Reno, just put like /backslash predictions, and then it'll bring up a window. And then that's what you enter the names at. Okay. Oh my god, this is bad. How much you want to bet is, you got this, oh.
Yeah, DC.
Yeah, it crashed.
It's the snack box. Yeah, the snack caused it.
Mm-hmm. You have to eat a snack before he starts. Fight K2 is awesome, ain't it? Well, yeah, it is.
Saying, Fight K1 I thought was the best thing in the world. I loved Fight K1. Fight K2 is miles better. It's so much better. Fight K1 was god awful compared to this.
Alright, we're back in it. And whenever you guys are ready to go, you can go. I wonder if they know it's going to be on Turbo 2. Oh no, that's Turbo 1. Okay, cool. So, you know, the one thing that's stuck on Snoopy... Oh, Sugar Honey Iced Tea. I think I know why. It has to be completed, Reno. It has to be completed. I completely forgot about that shit. That is my bad. No. It's you can still do it. You can hit like start prediction and it'll bring up a new window. That's what it should do. Okay, I don't even know what that combo was, but it worked. I really don't even know what that combo was, but it worked. It worked out for damn die. Oh no, no, Pit. It's like there was a previous prediction in here. It was sort of stuck, so it's nothing about you, sir. Oh, get to it.
Impressive stuff, seriously.
Yeah.
Damn Die never ceases to amaze me, seriously. I know I'm a big fanboy of his, but seriously. On a snack box, beating Fax Claw, game one is not easy. I couldn't do it, that's for sure.
Oh, and
he's getting beats, yeah. Honestly, Fax should just slow down a little bit.
Oh, man.
And I convincingly take this. Good start for Fact. Demdai kind of playing this like how he plays Okenclaw, putting him hugging the corner and reacting to wall dives that way with jump back roundhouse exactly the same way. Nice block there. I don't even know which side he hit the block there. Nice preemptive jump back roundhouse there. Demdai on match point. Hugging the corner again. Jumps back into the corner. Ooh.
Oh, that's supposed to be DP. I know it was.
Definitely was.
It's tied up. Tied up 1-1.
It was really that super that gave him the round. Otherwise, it was pretty even.
That's a good block. That's a good jump back roundhouse. That's a good DP. What? Okay, stand roundhouse. And like I said, it's working out. That crowd, the stand medium kick with the trade. What a good throw by Demdai. It's on match point.
Let's see if he's going to close this out. Smart just to block there. Jump back roundhouses. Fak is not punishing those jump back roundhouses. I'm sure he could just do a crouch fierce and clip Ryu.
Yeah, he could. Oh, what?
And wow. Will die.
What a trade.
Dan medium kick for the win.
Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Which means Fak is in eighth place. Thank you, good sir. Now, the next match. The next match is going to be Assassin versus Demdai. So, you know, there's no breaks here, sir.
Demdai's going to have a lot of fun with this.
Yeah. Yeah, he is going to have a lot of fun with this. So
the hooligans. If Assassin knows that he's on Snackbox, which I'm sure he knows, he should just hooligan away.
Don't give away the answers.
Yeah, good point. Good point.
All right, they should be in game now. It looked like Reno.
They are.
Yep, they are. There you go. All right, good job. Hey, all right, thanks, Wolfpack. Appreciate it. Predictions are up for this one. So it'll be Demdai versus Assassin. They realize that we're in game, and then let's go. And folks in chat who can't see the top eight bracket, Super V posted a link right there if you want to take a look at it. I think it's pretty cool, so I think you guys should take a look at it also.
Yeah, I update it after every round.
Oh, nice sweep.
It's really interesting because Demdai's using unconventional methods to still solve like the problem at hand.
Yeah, like his core, his oh my god, what a super. Oh, return super. Okay.
Ooh. Yo. Like normally he'd DP there, but he's using like interesting normals.
You know,
whereas, yeah.
I was going to say, you know what's interesting, right? What's interesting, he did said that he has no DPs, right?
Yeah, he said that.
So he's basically using everything else. So it's like losing one of your senses. Every other sense is heightened up.
Honestly, this might make him an even better player if he can use normals for these situations instead of risk DP sometimes.
That's true. A weird looking hippo said, what's the deal with the snack block? I Google it, it looked like a normal stick. So it's basically a micro hitbox. That's pretty much what it is. Well, it's not... Yeah, it's like a micro hitbox. It's a smaller version of the hitbox. That's what it is. So... Riz is, Riz and Damdai took up the challenge to do it. Even myself, I took up the challenge too, but I didn't buy a snack box. I ended up just getting a regular hitbox. So, oh man, Rage a Noob? Wow. What are you doing up? Assassin is taking things over, but now we got a new color. We got the brown, yeah, like brown cami.
Ask, what do you mean by pro play?
Who's speaking? It's Mega Man speaking, Rage Noob. Do you find it difficult going back and forth between stick and hitbox? Sometimes, because sometimes I'm just like, I kind of forget. That's the funny thing is, I kind of forget.
Damdai on point. It's amazing. He's playing so great.
Yeah, he is. Can't you maintain eternal charge? Oh, Tusk Vision, you talking about the Gaffro box that Daigo made. Now, that got banned. Yeah, Geef Bro. Yeah, man.
Wow.
You can still bring this back.
Yeah, it's relatively close and he has super.
Oh my god, that's rough.
If he had DP, that was round over.
Yo, can you guys hear me?
Yep.
Hey, Riz, what's happening, man?
No, I'm just on the road. I'm on my phone. So, where are we at in the tournament?
Well, Damdai won his first match in top 8. He barely made top 8, just letting you know that. But he won his first match.
Snackboxing?
Yeah,
Snackboxing. Snack. He was 8th. He beat FAC to move up to the Tower of Doom. Now he's fighting Assassin. It's 1-1.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Why? What did you think I said? You think I said something else?
No, I know you said fuck.
Oh, okay.
My response to that was, oh, damn, I barely made it. Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Out there. I think you cut out, so I didn't hear the first part.
Sorry, I can't see the stream chat or the stream. I'm just literally calling in through cellular, but what up to everybody? It's your boy, Riz.
It's your boy.
Damdai on match point.
Yeah, Assassin has been a Shoto killer.
Assassin did use style.
I'm just guessing. Yo, he did the hooligan, but yeah. Damdai reacted with the crouched fierce.
You know what's so funny? He did that like the first game.
I can do commentary without matches, bro.
Assassin pretty much walking Damien to the corner.
Yeah, walk up, crouch a medium kick.
Yep, exactly.
Damdai just pressing low forward every now and then and shit. You know, doing jump back roundhouse. He got himself in the corner.
Yeah, exactly. He's in the corner.
Yeah. And now, basically, Assassin's gonna get super and just at some point do empty jump super because Damdai, you know, he's hoping Damdai misses the low roundhouse. Anti-air.
Well, so Damdai takes it.
You thought that was the case.
Good stuff to Damdai. Amazing. Beating Assassin with the snack box. It's interesting, Ritz, because he doesn't have a DP. He's using normals.
Normal.
To deal with special moves.
Yo, boss.
I mean, it suits Damdai's style.
So the spinning back fist, on one occasion he used sweep to hit it. On this last occasion, he used low forward.
Those are the better buttons.
Yeah.
Choi Boy is the only one that does fierce DP on that shit because he's the Macrolorian.
Yeah.
Anyway, so was, yeah, thought I'd hop on if I get back home on time.
Yeah, when he, I don't know, you're kind of cutting out, but
Yeah,
if you do
cutting
get
out.
back in co it, if you do get back in time, yeah, we'll be here, maybe.
All right, cuzzos. All right, later.
All right, later, bro. Alrighty then. Yeah, I heard the man. That was Riz. Okay, so next match, we're gonna have Damn Die versus Demono Debian. So.
Whenever you guys are ready.
Okay, and Reno. And Reno is flexing his troll amount. Of course he is. So at this point right now, let's go ahead and get into game. Don't bet on me, people. Yeah, I completely agree. Don't bet on Damn Die. Like, really, just don't, because he could lose. He could lose. He could lose. Predictions, please. Reno, buddy, predictions, please. All I got, yeah, all he has is all he has is just basically, playing, pretty much regularly, but yeah. Alrighty, predictions are up. Shout outs to the Wolfpack Reno. So we're pretty much gonna get Ryu and Chun. Demonio is against the guidelines for some reason. It's weird. I don't know why. Even both names is against it. I don't understand why is that. It's kind of weirded. But it is what it is at this point. All right, so we got round one. So Damn Die. So at this point, Damn Die is going on the offensive. So kind of makes you wonder, why is he going on the offensive? What do you think, Super V?
You can't anti-air efficiently against Chun. And I'm assuming he doesn't want to deal with Chun Super to avoid it at all costs.
Ow.
It's so funny. He's just using different methods to win rounds. Ooh, tried to whiff punish that a low forward, but it's not easy to whiff punish Chun low forward. Demonio.
Kayla points out that what makes this match hard is that Chun-Li gets to build super. I don't know. At times, you both can. You know what I'm saying? You both can, especially like you see at this range. I know Chun's gonna get hers faster than Ryu. All right, that's a good jump. That's a good jump. He doesn't need to worry about super. All right, good counter throw.
Assuming the Ryu wants to play offensive
Yeah.
to negate Chun's meter building, kind of how Guile would play against Chun. Yeah, super Ryu super is not as effective as Chun's, for sure.
And Chun with super is hard. It really is. You really gotta look for what she's doing in order for you to get to clip her.
Yeah, maybe you'll Shinku a Chun Fireball.
Yeah, that definitely works.
You're probably gonna do jump strongs against Chun's jumps and then super juggle that way as well.
Yeah, he has to be careful because Demonio got super. Oh, like, see? Like, right
Yep.
there. Right there. Exactly, right there. Good job by Damn Die, though.
Yeah, I'm taking game one.
bust out them damn diapers.
I don't want to jinx him, so I'm not saying anything. Wow, you'd see a DP normally there by Damien. But on Snackbox, you see a stand medium kick to anti-air. Is Demonio using a Snackbox too? Or is Damdai just that good on Snackbox?
Legit, he's legit. Can't recall seeing Chun's to the fireballs to his colors. Well, Rage and Noob, which we have here is a color pack by Mr. MPG himself that he edited this down to the Super Flash and all. Pretty impressive.
Raging Noob, Americans make the best color packs. No, I'm joking.
Oh my god, yo, Grimba TV with a raid of 21 people. Yo, Brazil in the house, and Damdai takes it. Brazil in the house. Hello, everybody from Brazil. How you guys are doing? Thank you all. Thanks for the raid, Grimba. Greatly appreciate it. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you. Everybody's tuning in. Welcome to the stream. You know, it's your boy here, Mega Man X. And we got the partner in crime and the ho-ho Super V. And we're doing another episode of Monday Night Turbo. Episode 214. The difference is, this is Maturino based. So, it's Double XP Monday. That's what I like to call it.
And just for you guys tuning in, Damdai was in 8th place after Swiss. He's using Snackbox, and he's making his way up. Pretty impressive stuff by Damdai.
Yeah, X64 with the Prime sub, with a one-month streak. Greatly appreciate it, buddy. Greatly do. All right. Now
they are in.
Yeah, they are in game, in-game, obviously. So, alright, we continuing on. We got another match coming up. Another Chun Ryu mirror. I said mirror.
Mirror.
You might as well just call it a mirror from the last match anyway. So that's basically what's coming up right now. So now we got Damdai versus Scuzz Bucket. So it's gonna be another Ryu versus Chun. Yo, Shoryu Novento. Thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciate it. Mega Man, I challenge you. You challenge me? we'll play after. After the tournament. We'll play after. Scuzz Bucket changing the stage because he wants to go to Hong Kong. I mean, no fault there. It's just as good as Cammy's, I believe.
Honestly, I'd go to Sim stage against Damdai. Make it harder. Fast stage. More random.
Make it does more random, but Scuzz is doing, oh, jump over the super. Punish with the sweep. Yo, Zakurai. Thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciate it. Oh my god, jump in medium punch? Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't forget the annoying elephants. Hey, listen. Nothing's wrong with the elephants.
Sound effects. Weird looking hippo. They add to the sound effects.
Don't you like the... You don't like that? Oh my god, the three-piece, no biscuit, and the stun. Why? Why? Scuzz, why? This is the shit I'm talking about. Why? He could have just rock bottom and call it a day, but no. See, you could have done that there. Look at the mouse cursor. It's right there. You could have did that. But I did promise I'm not talking about. Oh, ooh. What a super.
80% gone.
Okay, super chip. Oh, good throw by Damdai. Oh, you
horse.
You thought he was gonna sit there.
No, Scuzz doesn't sit. Scuzz doesn't sit.
You thought he was gonna sit there. Yo,
Tech.
Yo, Tech Monkey. Yeah, Junex.
Tech, be at the barbecue.
Junex
you better
in
be there on Sunday.
Junex in game. How are you, bro? But that's my other brother. I feel like me and Tech, you know. Yeah, we're soul bros. But shout out to Tech Monkey, man. And the flip kicks. Oh my god.
It's looking like the end, almost the end of Damdai's magical run on Snackbox.
Magical.
Oh.
I guess this is, I feel like this is probably for him is a really good test anyway.
Yeah.
It's a good test for him. See how far he'll make it in tournament. Oh my god, this might. Oh, what a super.
Oh.
Oh. That was
inverted
super.
The combo, that was it. Oh, he had many opportunities there. This guy's just gonna build meter.
He's gonna jump back and forth.
Yep. Super.
Yeah. You know, on stick, Damdai would have got that.
On stick, Damdai would have won a while ago, I feel like.
Yeah. And thus, that's the end of Damdai. With him losing in fifth place, which is not bad. Not bad. Good stuff to Damdai. Good try. But you got fifth place, so hey, you have to end it. Okay, I'll end the predictions. Give me a second. Choose outcome. Scuzz. All right, there we go. Top five payout or top three? Well,
top three.
It's top three because we didn't get to over 300, or else it would have been top three. I mean top eight. That's what I should say. So. Oh well. Next. We got Pit versus Scuzz Bucket. So let's get this underway. How? Well, he's playing on the Snackbox, Tech Monkey. He is. He's playing on the Snackbox. Alright, so let's go ahead and get Pit versus Scuzz Bucket. That's Super V. Cry.
Oh, you were pink too.
Yeah. Double. What? Remember, folks. Chill that Maturino. Maturino is still live at this point. We're currently at $168. So, I greatly appreciate folks doing the sponsor crest. So, keep at it, please. Let's try to get to 170 or so. They still got a while to go. Alright, so look at Scuzz got $872. Oh, nice.
It definitely wall dives a lot more in this match.
Yeah. The funny thing about this match is Scuzz really tends to corner himself just to give him the advantage, which is not a bad strat. But it's like, you know, I feel like this is where Scuzz, where his defense shines more than his offense.
Yeah.
So it's like, he has to do it. Oh, see, like right there? That forward fierce was so good.
Super? Didn't get super.
Oh, Pit just slid right into them DMs. Hydrate? Okay, yeah, I've been hydrating. D's? Yeah, you know what? I gotta put a command for D's. Yeah, Shin Magnus. So we're using a color pack that was currently made by Mr. MPG. Wherever this guy... Hold on. Well, he went offline. So, you know what? Let me go ahead. I'll give you a link, right? If you're interested in this color pack, that's the man who created it. And also, when you get a chance, just give him a follow on Twitter, because he's the one who did it. So, this is really good work that he did. Oh, legs.
Legs are so good. It's crazy.
Yeah, not a problem. Thank you for dropping by and asking.
This guy's adjusting pretty well in this game, too. Nice early claw there.
Oh, nice fierce. Oh, my God. Is he the problem with that? That sucker leaves him in place. I don't know if that kind of helps him or hurts him.
Yeah, I don't know, but I love how Scuzz is just hugging the wall to avoid cross wall dives.
Yo, these green fireballs. Oh, nice jump back medium.
Despite that, I still feel like Pit should try cross wall dives, because if he gets to the other side, the other wall,
oh boy,
probably be a bend over.
Oh my God, and that's it. And Scuzz is eliminated. So, with that, we're literally to our top three, which is pretty much all Mexico. It's all Mexico from here on out.
Mexico is taking over.
Yes, they are.
Taking over USSR.
Yeah, hey. No one takes over USSR, okay? Okay. No one takes over USSR. I'm going to say that one more time. No one takes over USSR. Didn't land a single upkick. Yeah, I feel you, man. But good try, though. Good try.
Well, Scuzz, if Space's wall dives well, you're not going to get up kicks. He's just going to punish you for them.
And also post your top 8 brackets in there. Mr. Roy Bizzle in the house here. What's going on, Roy? How are you, good sir? It's been a while since I've seen you. Hope things are good, bro. Alright, now, with this, we are feeling like Tuesday Night Fights. Why are we feeling like Tuesday Night Fights? Because this is literally the matchup that we always see. Literally. So we got 8-0 with Old Ken versus Claw. So...
This match can go either way, which is why I enjoy when they play.
Yeah. Oh, nice Tatsu. Oh my God. You hit him with the cross. Shout out to cross, by the way.
Oh, I have to hit up cross. See if he's going to come out.
Yeah.
It was his birthday, like a few days ago, too.
Facts. A few days ago. It's kind of crazy. Him and Dan Dye's birthday is almost, pretty close by.
Is it a day apart or 2 days? Something like that.
About like 2-3 days apart. And 8-0 goes right back to hugging the corner. But you do realize with old Ken, he has to hold that throw, though. Oh.
Honestly, the more I watch Claw fight these other characters, Oken, Chun, the more I feel like Boxer probably does the best against Claw. Boxer has like a lot of options for Claw's setups, wall dives, grounded attacks. seems pretty hard for these other characters to deal with wall dive correctly and efficiently.
Yeah, that's true. Nice up kicks. Oh my god, what a reversal DP. Up kicks again. Okay, that's a good trade for your pit. Oh my god. Yo, what are these DPs, bro?
Yeah, Shin Magnus, good point. It seems like it would be hard to fight against a boxer for a long set. You're bound to just get worn out as the set goes on.
That's a good throw.
Nice and fit.
Oh, he went for it twice to see if he was gonna do it again. But Pitt was ready with the blocks. Good job by him. Oh, nice fierce DP. Well, no kick Tatsu there. Just to get something started. Okay. Good
great punish. Really equalized the health there with that flip kick.
Oh my god, the jump in is good. Oh, the poke! Pit still has to be... Okay, I'm about to say.
They both got nervous there.
They did, yeah. So now, it's tied up 1-1.
Who's going to take it, Mega Man? Who do you think's got game 3?
Well, if Pit plays the way he's been playing since that two round, that last game, I think he would take it. But 8-0 right now is like this man is like Terminator. He's like, give me your clothes, basically going in right now.
Pit left his claw on the other side of the stage. He's just using his fists now. Nice DP by Ken. By 8-0.
Yeah, match point for 8-0 though. Ow, he just gets poked. But these max distance slides are pretty hard for Ken to deal with as well. So it's not like he's like getting away with not doing anything.
Yeah, and Mega Man, it seems like at that range at max distance slide, Claw's normal, a lot of his other normals are working out at that range.
Yeah. Because Ken has to hold that. Because his only option is either he could Tatsu, but it's a risk. Because he could get punished, either he could DP, but he has to get pretty lucky at seeing a normal come out. See, like right there, A0 is just literally holding the block, just waiting.
It seems like at this max slide range, it's easy for Claw to whiff punish whatever Oken does.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what a DP.
Don't even wall dive, Pit. Just slowly chip him out like this. Don't even jump. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, see what I mean? Yeah, that's all he has to do. That's literally all
that
he has to do.
That was great. Yeah, that was an amazing round. Just displaying Pit, Claw's abilities there. Great use of normals, slide, spacing, footsies.
Yeah. Because once he's spaced too, he's also keeping charge as well too. So if you try to jump in, that's easy flip kicks for him as well. So
hard to there's no need for Pit to even jump. Just slowly chip him away. If H0 can't DP that roll, it's free chip for Pit, which he was unable to DP those rolls. And we are at grand finals.
Yep.
Pit.
Yeah.
Grand nice.
Shin Magnus with the follow. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you very much, bro. But all right, grand finals. So we got Hokuto versus Pit. This right here is going to be 3 out of 5. This is only 3 out of 5. There's no resets, no nothing. Yo, G-Structor, thank you for the follow. Greatly appreciate it. Shig Madness is the best claw from Brazil. Oh yeah, I've heard. Totally heard. I've seen his matches. His matches is pretty sick.
Isn't he the best player from Brazil? Or one of them, if I'm not mistaken?
So, it's between him and Flavio Ryu.
Flavio? Liga Ryu? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I haven't played Shin Magnus. I played Flavio. He's good. He's a very good Ryu player.
Mm-hmm. Oh, boy. It's time to guess. Okay, so what we got here, Hokuto is the... I want to say like the darker blue claw, which he is, versus the tan claw.
It's funny to see Pit do so many wall dives because he doesn't do this many in his other matches.
Yeah. You know, the funny thing is, in this matchup, I feel like you kind of have to. He poked him out of the air. Oh, good throw by Hokuto. That was a good awareness.
Flip kick. Oh, he did the back flip instead.
Oh, what a...
This is crazy. Oh, no wall dive. Wow.
Wow. Poked out of the air. All right, round 3.
This is a crazy match.
Yeah, I can't really commentate this match. It'd be like, all right, well, you know, Claw wins, guys. Claw wins. So.
This is Claw's hardest match.
Yeah, himself.
No, seriously.
It's himself. His greatest opponent is himself. Good job, Ayakudo.
Great, yeah. His biggest enemy is himself, seriously.
Yeah.
He tries to hide behind that mask.
Oh yeah, I gotta have a chat with Grimmer TV though, eventually.
Wow. It seems like Hokuto's gonna make the comeback on this round.
Ow.
Oh, nice.
You have got to be shitting me, bro.
He just waited. He just waited until Hokuto landed and punished.
Yo, spectator crashed?
Did it really? I'm still going.
I'm back, though.
Oh, okay.
I'm back with
you
these...
You scared me there.
Yeah, I'm back with these ass colors. These ass colors I'm looking at. Oh, my God. These colors are so ass.
And Riz is streaming right now with Damdai. He's gonna try to take our viewers.
Yeah. The fuck?
I know. You could have waited until after, seriously.
Yeah. It's all good. Not enough purple?
King Reno.
Oh, what upkicks. Oh my god. Oh, guess.
Oh,
what? Funny. Yo, hitbox collision, boys. Oh my god. What a. Wow.
Wow. Wow is right.
Okay. Alright. So, Hokuto is 2-0.
Yeah.
Is Pit going to make a comeback? Or is Hokuto going to take it?
It's unfortunate because both of the games could have went either way.
Yeah. Both of them could have definitely went either way. Always nice to see SF2 action. Thanks for streaming. Yeah, anytime, man. I greatly appreciate the follow.
Nice flip kick punish.
Good block.
He needs his claw.
Yeah, the funny thing about
now Pitt, both of them.
Yeah, the funny thing about Pitt is he could go. Oh well, he could fight without the claw though. But at that situation, it's not feasible. Kudos at tournament point. FYI, prize going to the highest placing hitbox user. Yeah, you thought that was gonna be the case. You get a consolation prize of $1. But back to this, and this is still going on. Oh, what a wall dive by Pitt! Oh, caught him flipping.
No punish on the back roll, but
okay,
gets a there.
Is Pitt gonna be on the board? Or is Hakuto still taking it?
Oh, missed wall dive.
Okay, that's some good patience by Pitt. Oh my god, this might be it. Yeah, of course. Of course, because Hakuto could do that. he could totally do that. He could totally do that. Just cause.
Good stuff there by Hakuto. Good stuff by Pitt. GG's, guys.
Yeah.
Very entertaining finals.
GG's to everybody. And, hey, greatly appreciate everybody coming through. And, winner is Hakuto. Second place is Pitt. Third place is 8-0. So, the prize does go to the top three. So pretty much you know the drill. Send me your how do you guys get paid? Is Maturino?
Through Maturino? Yeah, they just need to add their name to the participant list.
Oh yeah, that's right. Make sure you add your names to the participant list, please. And thank you. So you can get your Twitch bucks. But it's been fun. You know what I'm saying? This has been a really, really good stream. Like, shout outs to all the raids and everything. I mean, this was fun. This was a good turnout. I greatly appreciate everybody coming through. Just a reminder for folks, for those who just got here and want to know more about Monday Night Turbo. Just letting you know, we do this every Monday, 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific. Pretty much every last Monday in the month is considered double XP, which means it's going to be Maturino based. And pretty much money is on the line. So we'll return back to the normal ways of doing things, which means there's no Maturino or anything like that afterwards. Hey, Pitt, thanks for joining, bro. Really appreciate it. Congrats on second, though. And definitely tune in. I greatly appreciate everybody dropping by. Grimbo with the host, all the follows, Test Vision with the host. Greatly appreciated. Bazooka with the host also. Greatly appreciated also. So let me just make sure I chill one more time. And there's Tuesday night fights. Just letting you know, Riz... Usually he streams Tuesdays tournaments between Alpha 2 and ST. Basically, tomorrow is going to be Alpha 2. So there's no ST this week. It was just me. So when you go ahead, you're going to be shill. You do shill at Riz, at Riz 1. And, you give my homie a like and follow. And not to mention, he does Super Lore Boys. If you definitely want to join the Discord, because it's pretty much like the ST Illuminati. We pretty much tell about everything there. And he just did the episode for Boss. He finished recording, so it's going to come up soon anyway. Then, speaking of Mexico, they also have their Mexico Mass series. Basically... they stream every bi-weekly with their tournament. For ST, it will be under Hakuto's page. So if you go ahead, you go ahead and give Hakuto a follow and a subscribe as well. That's the homie as well. Give him a follow as well. He's blast playing retro, which pretty much was ST or something else though. But give him a follow though. And last but not least, the Super Lucha Caeta postcards. It's $10. So if the Match Arena could be left open, I'm gonna leave the Match Arena open until if anybody is still interested in trying to buy the postcards. So it's gonna be right there. So definitely buy it. It's pretty cool. Shout outs to 80's wife for making it. And two X in the Mirror 6, which is the Star Cup edition. It's gonna be, well, it was supposed to be the 30th, and it was supposed to be this Sunday, but it gets pushed off. Riz will come up with a date in regards of when it's gonna come through. So definitely tune in and pay attention. And last but not least, Super Lucha Caeta. Super Turbo Mexico versus USA Fight Night. It's very bi-weekly. Definitely tune in. You see the best of pretty much the US or Mexico to offer. And enjoy it in terms of the fight night. Alright, folks. Well, with that being said, I greatly appreciate everybody being here. Right? It's been a blast. Literally a blast. I think this is pretty much the most that I've gotten some viewers here, but I greatly appreciate everybody being here. I don't know what to say. Like I said, we try our best to keep the fight alive, you know, keep the spirit of Monday Night Super Turbo alive, and I greatly appreciate everybody being here. Anything you want to say, Mr. Super V?
No, thanks again, guys, for joining. Definitely enter next week.
Yeah. With that being said, we're just gonna go ahead and raid Riz One anyway, because he's also playing some super turbo. Well, not really super turbo. It's actually it's actually my favorite game, is New Legacy. Yo, CalSun10, thank you for the follow. I greatly appreciate it. Really appreciate that. But alright. Well, with that being said, everybody, this is your boy Mega Man.
And Super V signing out.
Yeah. Really appreciate everybody. We catch you all soon. So you all barbecue. Have a good night. Oh yeah, barbecue. I have an offline barbecue event Sunday. Starts at 12 p.m. Tune in. It's a special event, I'm telling you guys. So see you all later. Okay, that was fun, man. That was actually the most viewers I ever had, though.